Fault system signifies location of recurring quakes. In this session, we will look at earthquakes in a flash. Specifically, by the end of this session, you should be able to infer that earthquakes create faults, determine the anatomy of an earthquake, and discuss the significance of seismic waves on the discovery of the layers of the earth. Faults are location in which energy gets stored as elastic potential energy from plate movements. Over time, this stress from compression or stretch returns to its original form, releasing stored elastic potential energy into kinetic energy in the form of an earthquake. In order for us to understand earthquake further, we also have to look at its anatomy. The location in which the earthquake starts is called the focus or the hypocenter. The energy travels to the surface as earthquake, where directly above the focus is where the epicenter is located. The epicenter is where the strongest earthquake is felt. It is also where most destruction happens. When an earthquake occurs near or under the seabed, it creates higher than usual tidal wave, which is called a tsunami. Kailangan na malaman kung saan makikita ang mga fault sapagkat ito ang magiging basehan kung ano ang magiging epekto nito sa mga tao base sa mas maigting na pag-aaral dito. Habang mas aktibo ang mga fault, ay mas mapaminsala ito sa mga tao. Kapag ang fault naman ay malapit sa dagat, ay maari pa itong lumikha ng malalaking alon na lalong mas mapaminsala sa atin. Dahil sa mga pag-aaral sa lokasyon ng mga fault, ay maraming buhay ang nasasalba dahil naiiwasan ang pagtatayo ng mga estruktura malapit dito. Seismograph is one of the equipment used by seismologists to measure and record movement on the earth. Seismologists measure in terms of intensity and magnitude, wherein intensity tells how much an area was shaken, while magnitude describes the total energy released by an earthquake at the focus. The intensity is stronger near the epicenter but becomes weaker farther away from it. Gamit ang mga datos na ito, ay mas naiintindihan din natin ang istruktura ng ating planeta. Based on the seismic waves produced by earthquakes, we were able to infer that the planet is composed of three distinct layers. How do we know this? Seismic waves or body waves have two forms, P waves or primary waves and S waves or secondary waves. Both of these waves travel deep beneath the earth. However, P wave as the fastest wave and as a longitudinal wave can travel to both solid and liquid, while S waves, aside from traveling slower, is also a transverse wave which can only travel on a solid layer. As these waves, when detected, estimate to what forms the internal structure of the earth. The boundary of the earth's layers where body waves get bent are called discontinuity. Mohori civic discontinuity is the transition between the solid crust and the semi-solid mantle, while the Gutenberg discontinuity is the transition between the semi-solid mantle and the liquid outer core. In preparation for earthquakes, we should be familiar with what to do before, during, and after. The key to effective disaster prevention is planning. During an earthquake, we should remain calm. A sharp mind is essential during this time for better assertion and decision making. After an earthquake, we should be all the more prepared for aftershocks and at the same time finding a safe spot to save yourselves and others. These are a few tips for earthquake preparedness. That's all we have for this session. Thanks for watching and see you again in the next one.